What's going to happen is the agent's going to tell us there are six devices there. Using A2A, agent to agent, now we're going to have another agent. These agents are going to speak A2A. So the agent is going to talk to the device over model context protocol, but the agent is going to talk to other agents over agent to agent protocol, which was developed by Google. We're not going to get into this in big depth, but if you want to know how is it the agents that are experts in certain domains are going to pass the information they know onto other agents, it's through agent to agent protocol. You're going to have agents working together in non-predetermined ways to solve problems. So as a controls engineer, I'm going to use an agent to scan my network. Then I'm going to use another agent to tell me all the tags, all the data points that are available there. And then I'm going to use another agent to set up all the communications pathways in a platform to start pulling all that data. Instead of me spending months to do connect, collect, and store, I'm going to be able to do that in minutes instead of months. So now what does that actually mean? Nature of work changes. We're working alongside agentic AI as a force multiplier. But what is the impact on manufacturers? Do you know how many assets manufacturers decide not to integrate to? Because the level of effort, the time, and the money involved in the connect, collect, store part drastically outweighs what they believe the perceived value or ROI would be on connecting, collecting, and storing. Now that those costs are going to come precipitously down, now all those devices that we left behind in the past, we can revisit.